do you produce?
Right now I'm producing steam out of my back. Hey guys, welcome to Steak Back, the show where we chill, eat and discuss nothing but heat. Why are you shaking your head so?
No, I'm agreeing.
Oh, okay, there's just checking. Heat, yeah. If you like comedians, if you like to laugh, if you like ex Sunday school teachers, ex soccer players and baseball players, then this is the guy for you, Mr. Kenwin Davids.
Are we?
How are you, brother?
All right, how are you?
I'm very well. Thank you for coming today. Giving us all your time. We appreciate you and we appreciate you for coming through. You know what this is about, right? Have you seen the show?
Yeah, I know what it's about. I'm looking forward to eating the side wings. I've never had side wings before.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
I've had front wings, back wings, left wings, right wings,
but not
eagle's wing. Wings of love, but never side wings.
Oh, Lionel Richie? Yeah. Okay. So, we're going to jump into some hot stuff here today. How are you, Spicy?
I'm alright, I'll do alright. I'm gonna cut, but I'll still manage.
I'll
pull through.
Okay, now liquor. Firstly, what we have is a samosa. Alright?
Never had a samosa before. What
is that right?
Yeah, never.
Okay. So a samosa is a driehoekie vleis cookie.
Okay.
Filled with mints.
Okay.
And chili from Lamise Zest Juice. Okay. Thank you for providing us with this today.
Yeah. Thank you, Lamise.
Watch you. We'll have a bite and then we can discuss about you, what you're about, where you are, what you're doing.
We can die.
Things like this. Quiet. But we must eat the whole thing up.
Yeah.
Lekker. Mmm. Crispy.
Mmm. Lamise, you got a little more, son. Mushroom. Got a kick to it, no?
Mmm. A lot of chili in there.
A shitload of chili.
Okay. So. Wow.
So.
That chili makes me high.
Did somebody kick a dog or something?
So. You're a comedian, a producer, an actor. How did you get this far? The other day you were at Rosebank College playing soccer for Steenberg in the Vodacamp.
Yeah, you know what, this is actually something I wanted to do since I was probably a teenager, and now I'm doing it. I just said, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna dial-a. See what takes me. I took a chance and I'm here.
Quite. How did it start? Like, what step did you take?
Did
social media help you or like?
Not really, but when I started comedy, social media wasn't so big in South Africa. So a friend of mine, I was looking for comics, professional comics, to do a show. To say Xma, yeah, no, I'm a professional. Kind of never done comedy in my life. So I took the chance, jumped on. But before that, I told myself, okay, let me just go try this comedy thing first, see how it works out. And then 3 days before that thing I signed up for, I jumped on a chili bar and then I had a little time there.
Yes, I wanted to speak to you about the chili bar thing. But after we enjoy the wing from side wing that you've never had before. I promise you are gonna fall in love.
Do you have a knife and fork or something?
I'm
from Mitchell's Plain, like we don't eat with our hands there.
Why not? The two fish fall out.
We spell the wing.
Lekker, no?
Lekker, yeah.
It's almost like a one. The wing to be the size of his whole bloody platter.
That's a tomato vibe with.
So, you won 3 competitions, if I'm not mistaken, in chili bar, no?
Yeah.
Standing in front of people like that, my bro, is it not a scary thing? Like I asked, we've had comedians on before, and I always asked him, like, how do you stand up in front of people and deliver a scripted joke? Isn't it difficult to do that?
It is difficult. Let me just take my umbrella off because I can't see the wings and I can't taste it. it's nerve-wracking. It doesn't matter how long you're doing it. You still get nervous when you're on stage because it's basically making yourself vulnerable. You're telling the audience, I've got stories, I want to tell you. I think it's funny. What do you think? So if they don't laugh, then it's like, fuck.
Oh, yeah.
So it's making yourself vulnerable in a space of strangers and just talking cock.
Oh yeah, so you gotta have a lot of courage to do that, eh?
You must, yeah.
Because I mean, we as people always thinking about what other people think about us and to go up and do that, I mean, that's a big thing. So big up to you for, for actually moving past that or using it as fuel to actually tala, which is why.
Yeah, you must.
Excuse me. Okay.
You were right, my bro.
No.
Okay, you're not the right. Okay.
The ulcers from the show is...
It was only the first wing.
I know. Hello, are you presenting? Okay, next one is jalapeno and lime.
I smacked this.
No?
Jalapenos.
Sorry, was that wrong?
And lime. Mm-hmm. Mm. Look how zesty that lime. Coming through nice and zesty. I like the... The jalapenos also coming through.
Listen, you were on an Afrikaans series called Arendsvlei recently.
Arendsvlei.
How did you land the gig there?
Through my agency. I'm with a talent agency that focuses on features, Perche artiste. And they hooked me up with the casting. I went and then I got it. And I'm happy that I got that, actually, because the thing is, man, it's a coloured soapy, it's a coloured telenovela,
mm-hmm.
directed by a coloured bra also,
okay.
coloured telling coloured people stories. So it's our stories that's being directed by our people, you know what I'm saying?
Mm.
So that's great.
It is, it is something good. I mean, our community or coloured community. Mm. What I notice is that a lot of people want to be better than the other, and I mean to be in a position where you can build each other up. It's quiet. That's what we're trying to do here as well. Build a little community and stuff like that. So, how are you feeling so far? How's the wings? Is it
nice?
That's like not so strong.
Huh? See, but I feel like I'm being set up for a trap now.
Everybody says that. Hey.
That when you said, it's not gonna
Look at here, this one. This is actually our guest, personal favorites. After this one, we're going to do a little gamepie called Los Becky.
Okay.
No, but Mango Habanero, oh, it's a Naga Viper. Sterone always does this. He like mixes it up, man, to catch you off guard. So we can go ahead and try this one.
I don't trust this. I just want to say to this camera, I don't trust this fucking winger. I don't trust it. I feel like they're setting me up here for a trap. Oh, it's sweet.
Mm. It's a mango. A banana.
Oh, it's a little aftertaste, eh?
Yeah.
Ah, my throat.
Okay, so. Woo! Somebody kick a dog. We're gonna go ahead and do the game with you now quickly. So, Los Becky for Kenwin is. What's happening?
It's hot in here.
I'm gonna rattle some questions to you. You are gonna say the. You are gonna say the first thing that comes to your mind when I ask you the question. You got it?
Yeah.
Why? Okay. How much is black?
4 and 60.
Simon says what?
Puspus 9.
When last did you dial? Did you dial? You lost your dollar?
You're making me think now.
How far is David's dope?
How far is David's dope? It's finished. David got a drinking problem.
Okay, it's actually a dope, but okay, dope. You got a problem, okay.
Yeah.
What is it like meeting Kenwin?
I would say it's fine, I guess.
Just fine.
Yeah, he's okay. Alright.
Who organized the boat?
Side wings. In a boat.
So, you went to school with Julius?
Julius, yes. I stabbed him in the back.
What was your first?
My first was baby boots as the first pair of shoes I had.
Okay, yeah. Thank you very much. That was very nice. How's your mouth feeling after the mango cheese?
It's feeling like it, but I'm gonna have some steady stumpy.
Once here. Enjoy it. Okay, because the last one is a bit of a tricky situation. Actually, the second last, or the last wing. It's called the Naga Viper, that's the pepper that we use.
Mm.
And then we've got a dab of, it's called Regret. So that's usually when you go home, you sit down, you're on the toilet, and then you think, you're sweating and you're regretting that you've done this today.
Is this little brain called, is that the regret? The
brain call, that is most very...
I mean the red. So like a tangerine.
That's the one. Mm. So... We're just going to go into that one and then we'll find out more about what's happening with regards to your producing and your radio and things like that, no?
Yeah, I just want everybody to see that I'm about to fuck my life up.
Right, though. Cheers.
Away, cheers.
Oh, not that side.
bite on this thing. Mm.
Ah! Decent. Okay. So you've you've into production as well.
Mm.
What is it that you produce? Scripts for shows, comedy. You're also part of the, this is just a question within a question, sorry, right? The Talk Cock Show with Simon Ojo and Yasi Barnes as well. Tell us about that, and do you also do some of the writing or producing? What do you produce?
Right now I'm producing steam out of my big. Okay. With regards to Tokak, it's three of us, we write our own things.
Okay.
So we work as a team and we get topics and then we write our own stuff on the topics. We don't tell each other what we write. Even though a lot of the stuff is improvised.
Okay.
With regards to my own personal production.
Man, is steady stamping it uit onder de Angelo glasses off, jacket off.
Nee, regards my own production, I have a comedy club in Mitchell's Plain.
Really?
Yes.
What's it called?
It's, you know, a premium sports bar.
Yes.
So I do a comedy thing there every first and last Tuesday of the month.
Okay.
It is one of the best comedy spots in the country. That's not me saying it. That's the other comics that are saying that. For people that it's had international guests.
Wow, Teddy. Nice.
People from Australia, Germany, UK, US, Sweden, India.
Uh-huh.
So that's what I do, and we've been running that for 6 years. And yeah, people must come out, especially if you're in Mitchell's Plain, or if you're from Mitchell's Plain, come and support. You won't regret it. It is one of the best venues in the country. Other than that, I do shows for when people book me. I put together shows for fundraisers, put shows together for schools, things like that.
Okay.
So I also give my services to the community as well.
Nice. Mm. That's important, Kenwin.
No? Important.
Seeing that you're sweating there.
I'm fucking sweating.
You want to cleanse your palate already?
I want to cleanse my whole life.
No, this is what you need to do. We put the whole thing in our mouth so that it moves around your mouth.
Is that ash, bro?
Yeah. Okay. You're going to be thick here. Okay, cool.
Nou, man.
Yes. Strong, man. Side me. Dessert, boys.
Lekker van die suiker.
So, tell us, what's next for Kenwin?
what's next for me?
Yes, like, what's next? Like, is producing where you eat the roof? Or do you plan on going on and maybe directing some shows, or maybe, you know, moving into that whole
right now
industry?
Right now I'm writing a script together for a sitcom, and I'm still writing it together. I'm doing the pilot, or writing the pilot for a call center based sitcom, because that's also where I come from.
Can't I be in it, man?
You know, I look like an agent. But you look like a customer service manskap.
I am a customer service manskap.
You look like a customer service. Yeah, you look like, thank you for calling. Yes, he's speaking to Dwayne.
So this, who do you need to present the script to? Or are you just gonna go do it on your own? And
right now, I'm still in the process of writing it. So when I'm happy with it, then I will obviously put things together, and hopefully I'll get some more writers as well, because I need more insight.
Yes.
You need more insight, especially if you're doing something.
Coming from the outside, in here now.
Okay. Hopefully, I've recently been in Iron's Play as well, so hopefully that will also pick up for me.
Yes.
So my focus is, my first love is always stand-up comedy. That's my first love. And then my acting bit, then my production bit, and then my writing bit. And I don't want to lose none of those focuses. I just want to get better in everything that I do. I've got the allergics, my sinus.
You're not marking what?
Yeah.
What are you saying?
Marking my success by achievements. I'm rather marking my success by my personal growth.
Why?
You know what I'm saying?
Nice.
Because I'm not going to look at somebody else's success and say, I should be getting that because I feel I'm better or on the same level.
Yeah.
I'm more watching out and seeing how I'm progressing as a person, as an individual, in all the aspects, all the facets of what I'm doing. And if I'm improving there, that's when I feel I'm doing well.
I know also that before, but I mean within the comedy and that, in the shows coming up, where can they catch you on the socials? We can also nominate somebody to come through onto Steak Back and join us for some eat here.
The next place I will be is at the fire station because my back is branding. And also I'm going to go to plumber because I'm leaking here. But follow me on the socials, follow me at my Instagram is at KenwinTheKing. It's the same as my Instagram and my Twitter. Follow me there, you can see what I'll be up to and what am I doing. I'm also going to be doing some online content as well. Because the people sound funny, so I must mama try to make them into love.
Why? Who do you nominate?
I nominate, and in my hand I only have one serviette with one name on it.
Right.
And my nomination for what's it, Steak Burg, no?
Hello?
Steak Big, not Steak Burg, Steak Big, for Steak Big to open my envelope. Mark Fitzgibbon.
Marky Mark!
Mark Fitzgibbon, if you're watching, stick at your bang down.
Kenwin, thank you very much for coming.
Pleasure, man.
It was nice having you. Is your back burning?
A bit, yeah, but you know what? It's not.
That's okay. I'll manage. It's manageable.
I'll manage.
Thank you once again, and you go on and do your thing, brother. We're rooting for you. Guys, thank you very much for watching another episode of Steak Back with me and Kenwin the King. Follow us at Steak Back on Instagram as well as Sidewing17. Also, Lemise Zest Juice for the samosas and the chili oils. Thank you to Rai Guy SA for shooting and putting us together for us, and Sneaker Cartel for the location. Watch us again. We're coming back with some more stuff, and you must keep wale. You still here? Nah, lekker man. Why did you subscribe to get notified about the next Steak Back episode? Come on guys, click, like, subscribe.